Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am in Raleigh because I'm going to see Sabrina Carpenter today for the Emails I Can't Send tour. I just got to my room and I thought this would be a super cute getaway solo trip to share with you guys, because why not? This is my graduation gift to myself for all my hard work and dedication, and I just wanted to give myself something. And here we are. I'm super excited. So I'm gonna show you guys my room. It's not much, but it's something. It's a great start and beginning of a new era for me, learning how to do things on my own. Here I am as my little gift to myself, a little solo trip. It's just for the night. I just got here, 3 o'clock. I just checked in and I kind of want to get crumble cookie while we're here, and it's only 4 minutes away. So I think I'm gonna head there so that I can try crumble cookie. I've been wanting to for the longest time. Everybody says it's not worth the hype, but I want to try it for myself and have my own opinion. And yeah, so I'm gonna go get my cookies and then we're gonna do a little get ready with me while I, you know, do myself up, my best Sabrina Carpenter-ish inspired look, and I'm gonna take you guys to the concert with me. I don't know how much, I don't think I'm gonna be able to bring this camera in there, but I'm gonna capture what I can on my phone. I gotta make sure to prepare for that because my phone likes to start acting up as soon as I get to a concert. Like, I never have issues with storage until I'm in a situation where I want to capture the moment. You know, is it only me, or does your phone know when you're trying to capture a moment? But let's go get our crumble cookie, girl. I'm so excited. I forgot I was gonna give you guys a little room tour before I, like, not destroy the room, but, you know, get settled in. So here's the door. You come in, right? To the left, I have where there's air conditioner, a chair, a lamp that I couldn't get on. I don't know if it's not plugged in or if it's broke. This side table with a lamp, the phone, alarm. I have my safety keychain. Need to have that on standby, out and about the safe. This little drawer that I'm assuming has a Holy Bible in it, yes. The queen size bed and this little picture. And then across from that is this desk with a lamp, a chair, can charge my phone here. I put all my stuff here out of the way. And then there's a TV, TV channels. They even have a microwave, refrigerator, some more drawers that, you know, stuff I won't use. And then there is this mirror so I can get a few cute mirror selfies before I get out of here. And here's my quick OOTD. This is the Old Navy dress that I showed you guys in my last video, my collective haul. So go check that out if you haven't watched it. And I just paired them with my Uggs for today because we're on chill. And then I just have these hoops in and my everyday necklace. And then over here is the bathroom area. So over here is just an iron board, all this, which I probably need to go ahead and hang my dresses up because one of them is like, needs to be hung up. Towels, picture, some little coffee stuff, I won't use that, and some extra shit. Coffee maker, sink, this other big mirror with this nice lighting. Ooh, we're gonna get some really cute pics right here. Mm-hmm. Blow dryer that I won't use, toilet, some toiletries, the shower, and that is the room. I think it's perfect for just a one night stay solo person. So that's my little room tour. We got the goods. I got my crumble cookie. I'm so excited to try them. I was gonna wait until I looked cute to try them, but I just can't wait. I got this honey cake, has Teddy Grahams on it. It's fucking spilling. This one, oh gosh, I don't even remember which one that one is. I had a feeling he gave me the wrong one. Oh no, it's not. That's the chocolate. I ran out of room on my camera, but I said this was honey cookie or honey cake. This is supposed to be chocolate chip. Kind of looks a little suspect, but that's what it's supposed to be. This is birthday cake, and this one is pink sugar cookie. Looks super good. My mouth is literally watering, and I wanted to wait until I looked cute for you guys. I think I'm still gonna try because it's 4 o'clock. I told myself I'd start getting ready at 4 o'clock because I'm going to wave my hair, and that's gonna take a minute. And then I'm gonna do my makeup, which takes a minute. But I went to Ross because I got this dress. I didn't show you guys my dress options, but now I'm kind of almost dubbing the dresses all together. Oh my gosh. But there's this House of CB dress I got like 2 years ago that I intended to wear for like Valentine's Day, but I had no lover, and then I was like, I was gonna wear it on my birthday, and then I wore a different dress for my birthday, and then last year I went and did adventures for my birthday, so I obviously didn't wear a dress. But I thought this was really cute and gave Sabrina Carpenter vibes, because if you don't know her vibe, you know, I'll pop up some pictures, but the girl has a vibe and I kind of want to match it. You know, I already was a little iffy about this, but I had some black thong heels to go with this dress. Don't know where they are, and I think I left them at, well, I know I left them at home, and they're probably in the one place that I didn't look. So I went to the store to find some shoes and found something else instead. Don't think it's gonna go with this, and I already was leaning more towards this option, which I showed you guys in my last video. It's from Target. This gave a little more Sabrina Carpenter vibes. And then I have my sparkly silver shoes that I was intending to wear with them, because this just really goes. I mean, honestly, it goes with this too. So there's this, or there's what I just bought at Ross. I brought a pair of jeans from home, but when I went to Ross to look for some potential black shoes, I found these. And these give all the Sabrina Carpenter vibes, like, so now I'm very conflicted because I just feel like I have to wear these shoes. I think I'm gonna try them on with this dress because it can get away with it. It can get away. But yeah, this probably looks just crazy as fuck. But these shoes just give the vibes, and I love them, and I bought them. They're only 25 bucks. And then just in case I really do wanna wear those, I bought this shirt, the last one in a small with some hearts on it, because you know, emails I can't send. Red little hearts. And I just thought these with my light pair of jeans would be more casual but still giving Sabrina vibes, you know what I mean? So I'm just so conflicted. I don't know what to do. I think I'm gonna call my friend. But I'm really feeling this. Something that was at the absolute last minute, I'm kind of feeling this vibe more. So I wish you guys could tell me what to wear, but you're not gonna see this until after I decide. But let's call Gina and see what she says, because she solves all my quandaries. So I need you to choose an outfit for me. You know how Sabrina Carpenter dresses, right?
Think so.
Go look on her Instagram.
I think so.
But I'm gonna show you my three options.
And I think whatever you're gonna wear, the pink shoes.
Okay, yeah. The jeans and the little heart top with my silver jewelry. Mm-hmm. Okay. It's decided. You wanna say hi to the vlog?
Stuff later.
I'll watch myself later. Hello, vlog. Gina has decided.
Try me, something always tells me no. let it go. No, it's been going on for some time. It's like you got superpowers, better than I do. Can't touch myself from the other side. Always been no fighter. I can feel it's time to subside.
Okay, you guys, while I'm thinking about this, I'm gonna go ahead and talk about it. But I just graduated college, psychology major. I got my degree in psychology. Your girl has a degree. I'm college educated, okay? I'm so happy about it. You know what I found really weird is that I didn't cry at my mom's commencement. I didn't cry at my commencement. I didn't cry at all. Like, I just was very happy, felt very grateful. And then last night, I don't know what made me want to listen to The Climb by Miley Cyrus, but I remember my like second, either my first, I know I had been like my second or third semester that it kind of hit me. I started off as a nursing major, and in all of our like beginner classes, they would always say, if you don't care about actually nursing and taking care of people and you're only here for the money, then this isn't for you. And my Papa is a nurse, and that's like where I got the idea from. And I just knew with that degree I'd have financial security, so that's a lot of the reason why I chose that, was for like financial reasons. And they were discouraging you to continue if that's the reason why you chose it. And you know, I knew they weren't talking directly to me, but I definitely knew that message was directed at people like me. And I just ignored it because I was just like, you know, well, I don't know what else to do. Of course, growing up as a little girl, I always wanted to be a teacher, but teachers don't get paid anything. They play the hat, or they wear like seven different hats and don't get paid. They get paid little to nothing. But that is my passion. That's why I'm a substitute teacher. And you know, I thought about changing, and I did change it to education, but I just, even that didn't feel right at the time. I considered communications, but I chose social work, and then I didn't settle with psychology, but I realized how good I was at psychology. Like, I just understood it. I feel like that's a lot of something, like I try to educate myself outside of school. So I found that it interested me a lot. So I did psychology, and I've loved it ever since. You know, I love reading psychological books. I love reading self-help books. I know a lot about mental health. I really like to understand why people do the things they do, their behaviors, why they feel the way they feel. And you know, but it was a hard journey because it was just, I didn't know, especially in the beginning. You know, I think people just expect little 18-year-old teenagers to know what they want to do with their entire life, and you just simply don't. You kind of have to live life to really know what you want to do. I'm not saying that I wanted my college career to go any differently, but that song really got me through a lot because it's very true when they say, you know, life is a climb, but it feels so good when you get to the top of that mountain. It just feels so good, so rewarding, and I don't even feel like I'm at the top. I feel like I've only gone so far and I could go further. I definitely want to go back for my master's, and I definitely would love to make a video kind of going more in depth about my college experience. For all those going to college, still in college, going back to college, I've had a couple of peers in some of my classes reach out to me, and you know, a lot of people this semester told me they really liked my discussion boards. Like, they genuinely were interested, and it made me feel really good about myself because I must be like an educated queen.
you know, everybody was just into what I had to say, and it was very flattering, humbling, and nice. And I've had a lot of people, you know, email me and ask for advice about college, and I'm just like, girl, what did I say that you would like care about my opinion? But it's very flattering, and it makes me feel really good, and it's exactly what I want to do in this world, is help people find their way, encourage people, and inspire people. I'm very proud of myself because I feel like I've been doing that well, and I just want to find ways to continue to do that. So if you guys are interested, I'll probably make that video anyway because it's just something that I have a lot to say near and dear to my heart. College, you know, is a very iffy subject for a lot of people because a lot of people just don't believe in college, and that it can be beneficial. And where I agree, maybe in financial, you know, in our economy, it can sometimes not be as beneficial as it's, you know, played out to be, but it definitely is a beneficial experience for everyone. And I think you learn a lot about yourself. You learn a lot of life skills. Like, there's maybe not textbook things that you learn in college, but there's so many life skills to take away from it. So yeah, I just wanted to say that. I know this is about Sabrina Carpenter and a concert, but you know, the whole reason why I came was because of my accomplishment with getting my degree. So I wanted to put that in there and throw that out there. If you're going to college or if you're still in college, push through. When you get to the finish line, the first one anyway, it feels so good, and you're just gonna wanna do it again. It's like an addiction. So, you know, just wanted to share that tidbit. But now we can get back to the video. Oh my gosh, you guys, I love my makeup! All done with makeup and hair. Turn this down. I am feeling myself, got my jewelry on. Yes, got the hoops. And we are going to do a little cute montage-ish. Not really, because my bed is, it's not dirty, but you know, we're about to get our crumble cookie on, baby. I'm so excited to take a bite of that. I've been waiting for years, But I love these. These lashes took a lot. They're not even perfect, but look. I don't do all this, especially the lashes. Usually I have my sister do it. She explained the best she could on FaceTime. So I did the best I could. And I feel very gorgeous, beautiful. So yeah, let's do our little montage. Oh, this dress, or this dress. Ah, it's you. These. Perfect. This. See ya. Hey. I'm in love with this look. The makeup, A1. The hair, beautiful. I tousled it to the side because I love it. Just this look. It's giving me everything. Come on, out of focus. Come on, get your life. OOTD. I love. Okay, full length mirror moment. It's a little dark over here, but here's the whole fit. I am so in love. I'm so glad that I went with jeans and a top because I'm obsessed. I'm obsessed and I'm feeling myself. All right. Feeling myself. I'm feeling my. All right, it's crumble cookie time. Okay, I was getting a little bit of selfies and stuff, but we'll take intermission on that because we have crumble cookies to try, honey. All right, so the first we're gonna try is this honey cake. Oh my god, these things are humongous. Okay, here's this one. This one is called honey cake and has these teddy grams. That's good. That's good. That's really good. And I'm not the biggest honey girl. This one is making me really nervous because it's supposed to be chocolate chip. But like, why do the chocolates look so light? I kind of want to skip this cookie
I might, just because I have an allergy to a certain thing. Don't really want to say that online, but I'm pretty sure these are chocolate chips, but just to be safe, I'll skip that cooking. Plus it's chocolate chip, like what else do you guys expect it to taste like? And this one is birthday cake. Super excited about this one. Super pretty. Yeah. I don't remember if it was birthday cake or cake batter. Either way, I love cake batter. I love birthday cake. They're both bomb. This is good. I don't know what flavors other people have when they try a combo cookie that they hate it so much. But this is bomb. I love it. Maybe they just have flavors that, you know. Like, I really want to try, I don't know if it's Captain Crunch or like Fruity Pebbles that they had. I've seen somebody else with that before. That looks good too. And then this one is the pink sugar cookie, I believe. Come on, focus. Boom. But this is the pink sugar cookie, which I'm assuming is just regular sugar cookie with pink frosting. Mmm. That frosting is really sweet. I would say if I had to rank them, the honey cake is first, the birthday cake batter second, and then this one's in third. And then this, I'll try it. I know it's cookie chunk. I can tell it's cookie chunk. Oh yeah, that's chocolate. It's cookie chunk. But it's like a basic, truly a basic just chocolate chip cookie. Wow. I'm gonna have another bite of this honey cake because this, that goes hard. That's good. This was worth it. This was worth it. I like it. Now, is this some shit I'll eat all the time? No. But like, this is good. I like it. Maybe I just got really good flavors. But, it's 10 and 10 to me. I don't even need milk. I almost bought milk, but I don't drink cow's milk. So I was like, never mind. But these are really moist. They're not dry. Some people say they were dry. They're not. I'm a fan. I know y'all ready to see Sabrina. I'm sorry. But I love it. 10 out of 10. This is.
Oh my God, it's light up! Sad and heartbroken about it, or three, would you say that you're kind of like moved on from that and you're just like excited to get back out there on the streets?
Greatest time. I had so much fun. That concert was everything.
I went in, I went straight for merch because merch is my favorite. And I got this shirt, which I love. It has Sabrina on the front. Really cute. And then it has all the tour dates on the back. I don't know if you can see it. That's the best angle you guys are gonna get. Super duper cute. Picked this one up. I'm happy I got this one. And then I used the bathroom. The bathroom is pretty nice, whatever. It's a bathroom. And then where my view was pretty much in the back because I just couldn't get to the front. I mean, if I really insisted on pushing through people, but you know, I was in a decent place. I enjoyed it. She can sing live. She looked beautiful. And I just had a really good time. And it wasn't that bad for a solo trip. It wasn't bad at all, actually. I always, obviously, have always had, like, anxiety over doing things by myself. Not even just anxiety, but, like, I never feel like things can be as fun by myself as they could be with someone else. Like, just to enjoy someone else's energy, you know, while you're doing anything. When you're going to a concert or going to a movie, it's just nice to have someone else's energy. But, and I still stand on that. I do think things are different and are better with more energy, more people. But I am pleasantly satisfied and happy about how much fun I had even by myself. So that's nice. Growth, growth. But yeah, I just wanted to close out this vlog and thank you guys for watching, and I hope that you enjoyed, and I hope to see you guys soon. I always promise videos and then, you know, life happens. But I had a lot of fun today and I'm very proud of myself, and I hope that after watching this video you're inspired or encouraged or motivated to go on your own little solo trip. See you guys in the next one. Bye.